Elsa de Leon, which I'm sure is running a couple minutes late, but where is he at?
Back here.
Ponce! Mayday, Mayweather versus Guerrero, obviously, as you all know, May 4th, huge weekend for boxing. Mayweather is back. There's Ponce. Mayweather is back with a vengeance, facing a very, very difficult, tough, young, hungry, motivated Robert the Ghost Guerrero. We obviously not only wanted to make the main event as the highlight, but the undercard is just as important. When you put Abner Mares against Ponce de Leon, you're gonna get a fight. You're gonna get a war. You have a guy who is smart, intelligent, great boxing skills, big heart, goes forward, fights with passion. Ponce de Leon, a fighter who we all know for his punching power. He is the champion. This is the fight of his life. Come Saturday night, I know Abner doesn't like hearing this, and probably Ponce doesn't like hearing it either, but I can see a trilogy. This is a tremendous, tremendous fight. And what better place than to put it on that weekend, the 4th of May, celebrating Cinco de Mayo. Everybody is accustomed to getting together with the family, enjoying great food, and to top it all off, a great night of fights. That's what we're gonna get, a great night of fights. So I wanna thank everybody who was involved, who made this possible. Thank you, MGM. Thank you, Showtime. Thank you to all the fans, the media. We greatly, greatly appreciate it. Not only do we have a tremendous, tremendous semi-main event, but we also have, as a co-feature, Leo Santa Cruz versus Alexander Munoz, which will be a 10-round fight. Now, when you mention Leo Santa Cruz, you instantly think about excitement. You think about punches and bunches going forward. You think about heart and passion. That's what Leo Santa Cruz is all about. Alexander Munoz is a fighter who a lot of people don't know, but he's here to win. I've seen him fight. I've studied his fights over and over again. And this is gonna be a really, really exciting, very interesting fight to watch. So this is this was actually a fight that when we were looking forward to, because we know we are gonna get guaranteed action and fireworks. Also on the co-feature, another very interesting, and in my eyes, could be one of those fights where you just don't want to miss. You have Jay Leon Love against Gabriel Rosado, and that'll be a 10-round middleweight bout for the vacant NABF middleweight championship. I think this fight here, opening up the pay-per-view telecast, will be amazing. Jay Leon Love has proven himself. Rosado, he had that tremendous, tremendous fight Triple G, they call him, in his last fight, which gave a courageous and exciting performance. Rosado's a fighter who has no quit in this game. He fights till the end, fights with passion. I think, yes, this is the big opportunity that he should, that he's gonna seize, you know, and Jayon Love is thinking the same thing. So I think this fight really is going to call for an exciting, exciting matchup. So I'm really looking forward to it. I want to thank the sponsors. I want to thank everyone involved in making this event possible. A few things. Tomorrow, the final weigh-in will be open to the public here at the MGM Grand Garden Arena. The doors open at 1 p.m. and the weigh-in begins at 2:45 p.m. It's going to be streaming live on Ustream .tv/Mayweather vs. Guerrero. Also, I want to mention that Saturday, May 4th, the doors will open at 2:30 p.m. We have an exciting, exciting lineup, I believe, of more than 8 to 9 fights on the whole card. So you want to get there. You want to get there early. This couldn't be possible with obviously our partners, Mayweather Promotions, and to introduce to you and call up to the podium to say a few words. He is the CEO of Mayweather Promotions. That is Leonard Ellerbe.
Thank you, Oscar. On behalf of Mayweather Promotions, we would like to thank everyone for coming out. As Oscar mentioned, with every great main event, there's always a terrific undercard. But I wouldn't classify this as an undercard because obviously with the first co-feature, you have two outstanding fighters who you know are going to stand there and go toe-to-toe. And this is what the fans really want to see. This is definitely a main event within itself. Obviously, when it comes to Mayweather Promotions, we have a young group of rising stars. Over the last year, we signed about 6 different fighters. And the first one I'd like to acknowledge is Lanell Bellows. He'll be taking on Matthew Garrison, who's 2-0 out of Charleston, West Virginia, in a four-round fight. Next, we have Luis Arias, who's 4-0 with 3 KOs, better known as Cuba. He'll be taking on Donnell Livingston of Palmdale, California, in a 6-round super middleweight fight. Next, we have Ronald Gaville out of Romania. He's 3-0, and he'll be taking on Roberto Young, who's 5-6 with 4 KOs out of Phoenix, Arizona, in a 4-rounder. Next, we have Badu Jack, who's 13-0 with 9 KOs. He'll be taking on Michael Gabinga, who's 16-7 out of Ghana in an 8-round fight. To open up the show, boy, this is going to be a great fight. It all got started yesterday. These two guys have been kind of going back and forth, you know, over social network. You have two young guys who really want to go out there and put it on the line. I can speak firsthand to my fighter, Jay Leon Love. He came to me right after he fought his fight in Detroit. And he came to me and said, "I want to fight Rosado." I was like, "You sure?" He's like, "Yeah, I want him." I gave him a couple other names. He said, "Nope, that's the guy I want. Can you go out and make that fight?" I said, "Okay, let's do it." So I personally think this fight right here, to open up the show, is going to be a tremendous, tremendous fight. You have Gabriel Rosado, who's 21-6, with 13 KOs out of Philly. He's an outstanding fighter. He's coming off of a tough fight with Triple G. He had a courageous performance. And we know that he's coming. He's going to bring it. And it's going to be an outstanding fight. Want to come up and say a few words?
First and foremost, I just want to thank God for this opportunity. And Golden Boy Mayweather Promotions for making this happen. You know, I'm excited about this opportunity. You know, my last fight, I came up short for the world title, but you know, I got a taste of what it is to be at the big dance, man, and I want to be back on that big stage. So I'm excited about this fight. Jay Leon, you know, I know he's going to bring his A game. He's 15-0. But, you know, I don't think he has the experience that I had. And I'm hungry, and I'm determined, and I'm going to leave it all in the ring, man. And training camp went great, and I'm just excited. I want to thank my team, Michelle, and Billy Briscoe, my trainer, for having a great camp. And my mother is back there. She came from Philly. A lot of people from Philly is landing today, man, so I got a lot of support. So I just can't wait to open up the show and give the fans a great show, man. So thanks a lot.
Next young man, I took a personal interest in him. It was last year. I brought him into training camp to work with Floyd for the Cotto fight. It only took the first day to box Floyd, and I said, I gotta sign this young man. Outstanding fighter, a very respectful gentleman, something that you rarely see in this sport. I've been in and around the sport for a number of years. I hadn't met a young man who conducts himself like the way that he does. I'm very proud of him. He's, like I said, he's a very good fighter, but more importantly, I like how he conducts himself outside of the ring. And I think that he's a very special fighter, a fighter that who's gonna have a long, long career, and he's gonna be a force to be reckoned with at middleweight, super middleweight, light heavyweight. Next up, none other than Jay Leon Love himself.
Mayweather Promotions, Golden Boy Promotions. This is a great fight. I mean, much love and respect to Team Rosado. You know what I mean? There's no bad blood, but here's two young guys ready to put it on the line. I got a lot to prove. I know he has a lot to prove. He came up short in his last fight, but we all know he put on a good performance and showed a lot of heart and determination. Here's the thing. I know a lot of people think that this is, you know, a big step up for me and things like that, and I don't have the experience. I'm a fighter, man. I've been fighting all my life. This is what I do. You know what I mean? It's no step up for me. I'm ready to fight. You know what I mean? God blessed me with the skill, and I know how to use it. So we're going to May 4th. It's going to be a good fight. I will be victorious, hands down, and we're going to put it all on the line. Thank you.
Thank you very much. At this moment, I would like to call up to the podium to say a few words. He is the executive director of the Nevada State Athletic Commission, and that is Keith Kaiser. Keith.
Thank you. On behalf of the State and its Athletic Commission, I want to welcome everyone here to another great fight weekend. This is just amazingly great. Thank you, of course, to Golden Boy, Mayweather, and of course, Showtime here. Good to see you here in May, Stephen. And of course, the MGM Grand. This is, of course, a fight, both from the top all the way down, that has some great fights, some great athletes. It's great to be up here with 12 great athletes. Usually I'm up at the main event press conference with two. We have 12 great athletes up here on the dais. And this is a fight that could take place anywhere and sell out anywhere. And it's a great thank you to the MGM for having it here for Saturday. I recently read Pete Townsend's autobiography. That's the fun I have in my free time. And in there he said that destruction is art when set to music. Well, we don't need music in this sport. We have enough destruction, and we look forward to seeing some of that come Saturday night. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Also, at this moment, I would like to introduce to you, up to the podium, a man who has really taken the boxing world by storm. I can say that right now, Showtime has been doing a tremendous, tremendous job in presenting you exciting fights, fights that the public wants to watch, and breaking records in viewerships. This person has a goal, has a vision, has passion for boxing, and obviously makes it easier for him to make these great matchups because he wants to see the fight, the best fight the best. Let me introduce to you, he is the Executive Vice President and General Manager of Showtime Sports, Steven Espinoza. Steven.
Thank you, Oscar. When we, Richard, Oscar, Golden Boy, Floyd, Al, and Leonard, first started talking about this event, we immediately came to one conclusion, and that was that a world-class fight like Mayweather versus Guerrero deserves a world-class undercard. You know, that's what we put together, with a little bit of, immodesty there. These aren't filler fights. These aren't no-name fighters. These are name fighters, tough, meaningful matchups. And I'm really excited and very proud, honestly, to be involved with these fights. I'm especially proud on behalf of Showtime because several of these fighters have been groomed and developed, by Showtime. We have Jaylion Love, who was featured twice on Showtime last year, immediately got a lot of attention. Leo Santa Cruz actually pulled the trifecta, going from Showtime Extreme to Showtime to CBS. And to be featured on CBS at his young age is quite an achievement. And of course, Abner Bonas, who's been a staple at Showtime his entire career and has provided our subscribers with hours and hours of entertainment over his career. We're also very happy to be featuring Gabriel Rosado, Alexander Munoz, and of course, Daniel Ponce de Leon for the first time as well. But top to bottom, this is the highest quality undercard for any boxing event, I think, in recent history. In fact, on this undercard, we have, in my opinion, and the opinion of many people, probably two of the fighters that could have and should have been Fighter of the Year in 2012. In 2012, Abner Bonas fought the toughest competition he could find, and he dominated. We had Leo Santa Cruz, who went from, quite honestly, an up-and-coming, unknown boxer to being featured on CBS and generating almost 2 million people for his fight. Those, in my book, are the two co-fighters of the year, no disrespect to anyone else. But as for this entire card, though, every fight is, in fact, meaningful. This is the toughest fight of Jaylion Love's career. This is the toughest fight of Leo Santa Cruz's career. This is the toughest fight of Abner Mar's career. It's no exaggeration. All three of those things are true. I see Ponce de Leon and Bonas as the newest in the great history of battles between Mexican fighters. This is in the great tradition of Barrera Morales, Vasquez Marquez, and I think very soon we'll be adding to that list Ponce de Leon Bonas. A couple programming notes, as Oscar mentioned. The weigh-in will be live in a variety of places, live on Showtime, live on CBS Sports Network, live streaming on the internet. Our pay-per-view pre-show, Mayday Live, again, live on Showtime and live streaming on a variety of outlets. And for the first time in recent history, we're doing a live pay-per-view post-fight, thanks to our colleagues at CBS Sports Network. It's a side that, quite honestly, very few people get to see. What happens in the locker rooms and the post-fight press conferences, I know it's going to be riveting television. We're pulling out all the stops for this fight. I could bore you with all the technology. If you're watching the broadcast, you'll see it. Among other things, we're using 16 cameras for this fight. That's the most cameras, the biggest number of cameras that Showtime's ever used for a boxing event in the history of the network. That's how much we're committed to this event. As you guys can tell, I'm very excited. I'll see you Saturday night.
Thank you very much, Stephen. Also, I would like to acknowledge he is the president of the WBC, Jose Suleiman. Thank you very much for all your support. Gracias, señor Suleiman. Gracias por todo el apoyo. And for all the great things you've done for boxing. We appreciate it. Thank you. So now, I would like to introduce to you Team Munoz. Now this fight here, when we put it together, we, like I said before, we instantly thought excitement. We thought record-breaking punches thrown in a fight. That's what Leo Santa Cruz brings to the table. But when you have Munoz, Alexander Munoz, who is a fighter that, yes, not many people know, but he can fight. I mean, this is a real, true test. I mean, Leo has to be ready. I'm sure he is ready. He's prepared. But this is a guy who's going to bring the fight to him. And that's what's going to create such an exciting, exciting fight. So let me introduce to you the trainer. I would like to acknowledge Rafael Moron. He's the trainer. Rafael. He does have devastating punching power, this fighter. He's strong. He's knocked out 19 of his opponents in less than 3 rounds. He's a fighter that hails from Bolivar, Venezuela. Again, fights with passion, fights with heart. And this is the shot of his life. This is the fight that he knows winning this is going to put him on the map. That's why he's ready, and that's why he took it. With a record of 36-4, with 28 knockouts, Alexander Munoz. Alexander.
Buenas tardes. Saludo a todos los medios de comunicación. Me siento contento de estar aquí nuevamente por segunda vez en Las Vegas a hacer una buena pelea con Leo Santa Cruz. Sabemos que es un rival que está invicto, debe estar preparado como me siento yo ahorita al 100% de mis condiciones para hacer un buen combate y demostrar a mi pueblo, a mi gente de Venezuela, tanto como aquí en Las Vegas, que ahora es que hay explosivo para rato y vengo a ganar, a lograr el triunfo aquí nuevamente en Las Vegas.
I'll translate for him. He said, thank you all for being here. This is my second time fighting in Las Vegas. I want to put together a good fight. I know Leo Santa Cruz is a very good fighter. He's very tough, but I'm prepared for this fight. I'm prepared for Leo Santa Cruz, and I want to make all the fans proud and all my countrymen in Venezuela proud. So thank you once again. Enjoy the fight Saturday night.
Gracias. So now, Team Santa Cruz, I would like to acknowledge el papá, the father, the trainer, José Santa Cruz. Gran trabajo. Gracias. Thank you very much. Last year he fought 5 times. Was it 5 times? Back to back to back to back. And every single time he comes out, he gives an even better performance from the last. That's who Leo Santa Cruz is. He's improving, he's growing, he's getting stronger, he's throwing more punches, his conditioning is getting better. Leo Santa Cruz is becoming a fighter known for his boxing ability, but also the punches that he throws, working the body, throwing beautiful combinations. He's a fighter that people have come to admire, have come to respect for his abilities, and that's why we love watching him fight. So now, he's taken a break out of boxing for a few months and now fighting on the biggest stage in boxing this Saturday night underneath Mayweather-Guerrero. He has an exciting style, great punching power. He hails out of Guatamo, Mexico, living now in Los Angeles with a record of 23-0, 13 knockouts.
I give thanks to all the people that are here. I want to give thanks to Golden Boy, to Richard, to Mayweather Promotions, to Showtime for giving me this opportunity. And especially I want to thank Al Heyman, my manager. Ever since I signed with him, everything has changed for me. I've been getting better things. I'm really like happy. I'm excited because since I signed with him, he has helped me out a lot. He has been there for me every time I need him. He's there for me. And thanks to him, I was able to get my mom her first house that she always dreamed of. If it wasn't for him, I would have never got that, and for my family too. And I owe it all to him, so that's why I want to repay him by trying my best to going out there this Saturday and show the world who Leo Santa Cruz is. And I'm very excited for being on this big undercard. I think the biggest of my life. I want to show the world who I am. I train really hard. I know that Alexander Munoz is a really strong fighter. He comes forward, always and he could finish a fight with one punch, but we trained in the hard with my dad, with my brother, that we learned new things. We've been working really hard. And on Saturday, we're gonna give it a war, and I'm gonna go out there and try to finish him before the 10 rounds. So thank you, everybody. I appreciate it. Well, muy buenas tardes a todos. Les quiero agradecer por estar aquí. A Golden Boy, a Richard, a Mayweather Promotions, y a todos los que hicieron este show posible, y a Showtime, que me ha estado dando la oportunidad de seguir peleando en estas grandes carteleras. Y también quería agradecerle a mi manager, Al Heyman, que desde que firmé con él me ha ido muy bien, y pienso que él es el mejor manager que hay ahorita, y el mejor. Y desde que estoy con él, ha estado en mejores carteleras. La gente me ha conocido más, me ha agarrado más fans, y gracias a él yo tuve la oportunidad de comprarle la casa a mi mamá, que siempre había querido ella, y a toda mi familia. Estoy muy contento, y les quiero decir que estoy bien preparado para dar un gran espectáculo el sábado para toda la gente mexicana y a todo el mundo. Y que nomás que el sábado les voy a dar una gran demostración y voy a tratar de dar lo mejor de mí. Gracias.
Muchas gracias, Leo. And now, the semi-main event. Quiero hablar unas palabras en español, nomás de hacerles saber que esta pelea, obviamente estamos acostumbrados aquí en los Estados Unidos de celebrar lo que es el 5 de mayo, de juntarnos con familia y convivir y obviamente ver bonitas peleas en la pantalla. Ya se acostumbró a una noche especial, de lo que es obviamente la celebración, ¿no? de la batalla de Puebla. Pero aquí lo que es el México americano, lo que es el hispano aquí en los Estados Unidos, para nosotros es una tradición convivir este día tan importante, este día tan bonito. Y pues qué mejor de tener una gran batalla como Ponce de León y Abner Mares. Yo creo que esta pelea sí va a ser una tremenda pelea. Ahora les quiero presentar Team Mares. Primero les quiero presentar Ismael Mares y Frank Espinosa, que son los managers de Abner Mares, si están por aquí. También quiero presentarles, para decir unas pocas palabras, es el entrenador, y que hace un gran trabajo con Abner Mares. Hemos visto lo que es el entrenamiento, el esfuerzo, el empeño que le mete a los entrenamientos y el esfuerzo que hace este gran entrenador. Déjenme presentarles a Clemente Medina. Clemente.
Buenas tardes a todos. Nomás quiero decirles en español también que esa noche va a ser una noche donde todos van a disfrutar el 5 de mayo. Que gane el mejor. Nosotros somos los mejores. Por si le damos la mejor de las suertes, así es que van a ver una gran pelea. Vinimos con todo. Gracias.
Good afternoon. Thank you all for being here, and I just want to say that it's going to be a great fight on Saturday night, and may the best man win. We want to wish Ponce de León good luck, and we'll see you Saturday. Don't miss out.
He turned pro in 2005, representing Mexico in the Olympic Games in 2004. I remember that moment as if it was yesterday, where he had a fight which he was supposed to win. He won it hands down, and a lot of people, obviously across the world, got to know and admire a fighter for his abilities and his heart and his passion that he gives us inside that squared circle. He's defeated amazing fighters like Joseph Agbekpo, for the IBF Bantamweight World Championship title on Showtime. And he's been able to not only show his skills against fighters who stay in front of him or fighters who box, like Anselmo Moreno, who he beat, who just was an amazing, amazing boxer who was on his feet, boxing circles and circles. And Abner Mares had a tremendous, tremendous win against an incredible boxer in Anselmo Moreno. That's the character that Abner Mares brings to the table. He knows how to switch it up. He knows how to change his style around and adapt to his opponent. That's why we love watching Abner Mares fight. He does hail desde Guadalajara, Mexico, con un récord de 25-0 y 13 knockouts, Abner Mares.
Good afternoon, everyone. First of all, I'd like to thank Golden Boy Promotions, Mayweather Promotions, Showtime for really, thank you so much. Showtime has really showcased my last, six fights, and has done a tremendous job. People know me because of Showtime now. Golden Boy, everyone. What can I tell you? Like they said before, this fight alone was a main event, got put in this co-main event, and really is, you know, you got two main events in one card. You know, Mayweather against Guerrero, Ponce de Leon, myself. Two main events, two great fights. And it's going to be a good fight. It's going to be a tremendous fight. I want to thank Ponce de Leon, his team, for giving me the opportunity to fight him, to fight for the world title. It's my first time at 126 featherweight. And, you know, I want to thank him for that. I want to thank Golden Boy for doing that as well, the ABC, for giving me the opportunity. And I'm ready for this. You guys know me, I fight whoever, man. Like I said it before, I'll fight anyone, man. You know, as long as I give the fans a good fight, I'm with it. I train hard, you know, my coach, Clemente Medina, Luis Garcia, Mike Jr., my dad. I want to, you know, really, you know, my dad, this fight is dedicated to him. My dad just recently suffered about a month ago a stroke, but he's doing better now. So, you know, I dedicate this fight for him. And it's a tough fight. You know, I train hard. I'm ready. I added something different to my training camp, and it's called the Mexican Judo. It's you don't know if I'm gonna box, you don't know if I'm gonna brawl, but you do know I'm gonna win. Thank you so much, and que viva Mexico. Bueno, pues primero que nada, muchas gracias a todos. Que viva México. Esta pelea es una gran pelea. Le quiero dar gracias a Golden Boy Promotions, Mayweather Promotions, Showtime que me ha hecho el peleador quien soy ahorita, hasta ahorita. La gente me conoce por Showtime, es mi casa, es mi gente. Y qué les puedo decir, le quiero dar las gracias a Daniel Ponce de León, a su equipo, por darme la oportunidad de pelear contra él. Se la pudieron haber dado a alguien más, pero me la ofrecieron a mí, el CMB, por brindarme esa oportunidad, a mi empresa. A todos, ¿no? Quiero darle las gracias a mi equipo, Clemente Medina, a Frank Espinosa, a Mike Vital Jr., Luis García, a todo mi equipo. Gracias a todos. Esta pelea va a ser muy buena. Era una estelar y ahora la pusieron en coestelar, pero sigue siendo estelar. Creo que tenemos dos peleas estelares en esa noche. Disfruten de esa noche. Va a ser una noche mexicana. La vamos a hacer mexicana, Daniel Ponce de León y yo, y espero que la disfruten. Muchas gracias. Que viva México y Dios los bendiga. Gracias.
Thank you very much, Mares. Now for the champion, Team Ponce de León. Yeah, like Abner said, this was actually a main event on a separate card. It was its main event. But we obviously wanted to present to the public, to the world of boxing, a great card from top to bottom, and that's what we've done, huh, Leonard? From top to bottom, a great, amazing card. He hails out of Los Angeles, California, out of Guatemala, Mexico. He is a 2000 Olympian, and we've seen Daniel Ponce de León fight many, many, many times. Great wars, in-your-face type of style, There's no back in his game. He goes in there, he fights straightforward, punches like a mule. He knows the importance of this fight. He knows he has Abner Mattis in front of him, who is a very gifted and very talented fighter. In 2005, he won the vacant WBO title at 122 pounds. And at 32 years old, he's on a 3-fight winning streak, including in September of 2012 over Johnny Gonzalez to win the WBC Featherweight World title, which is at stake on Saturday night. He's obviously looking to defend it. Daniel Ponce de León conocemos por muchos años. Nos ha brindado grandes batallas, bonitas peleas. Es un peleador que pega fuerte. 4 y 4, 35 knockouts de Cuauhtémoc, México, Daniel Ponce de León.
Hola, buenas tardes a todos. Primero, pues quiero agradecerle a Dios por estar este día aquí, este día tan bonito. Agradecerle a Golden Boy, a toda la prensa que está aquí, y a todos los sponsors, a Fran Espinosa, a mi manager, a Mayweather Promotion, Golden Boy, a mi equipo también. Gracias por ayudarme a esta pelea. Y pues, ¿qué puedo decirles? Preparación, saben que nos preparamos bien, estamos listos para la batalla. Va a ser un 4 de mayo donde mucha gente va a estar pendiente viendo esta pelea. Y pues la gente quiere ver algo bueno este día, así que para eso me preparé, para dar algo, una buena pelea, dejar todo arriba del ring. Estamos listos, ya he peleado muchas veces en este casino aquí, me siento muy bien. Y pues espero, como siempre, darles buenas peleas y que disfruten este 4 de mayo, este sábado. Y pues ya, todo listo. Nos vemos mañana en el pesaje. Gracias.
Hello, good afternoon. Thank you all for being here. I want to, first of all, thank God. And I want to thank everybody involved, Golden Boy, Mayweather Promotions, the MGM, Showtime, the entire team. It's going to be a great fight. I prepared myself well. I fought here at the MGM many times before, and I'm going to put up a good fight. I prepared myself for a good fight. It's May 4th. Everybody wants to see a battle, and that's what I'm ready for a battle. So don't miss it. May 4th, and thank you all.
Thank you very much. También les quiero presentar a Yuka Morales, el entrenador, que también obviamente le ayudó a estar bien preparado. Así que gracias. Va a ser una gran batalla. This Saturday, May 4th, we will see an incredible, incredible event. We will see you there. See you at the weigh-in tomorrow. And right now, we'll pose the fighters for pictures. Thank you very much. Gracias.